Good morning, students. I am Murugesh Kinnar. You know, I am going to teach you physics in the 10th class. So, we are going to start physics from this week onwards. In this physics, first we are going to learn the topic on light, reflection and refraction. The nature around us is quite curious. We see beautiful greenery, beautiful night sky with the stars, full of stars, and in the daytime we see blue color of the sky, red color of the sky in the evening. So these are all curious things for all of us. So in this topic we are going to learn about these natural phenomena. The branch of physics which deals with the light, the phenomena related to light and natural phenomena, it is called as optics. Optics is a branch of physics which deals with study of light and natural phenomena related to light. So in this topic we study about light. Also we study about the various instruments that we use in our day-to-day life. Various instruments, like you are all knowing about camera, about telescope, microscope, especially mirrors. Mirrors are part and parcel of our life. Plane mirror, spherical mirrors such as concave mirror, convex mirrors, these are all the things that we use in our day-to-day life. So we are going to learn about these in this particular topic. So first of all, what is light? You know that light is a form of energy which enables us to see the nature around us. Light empowers the ability of vision. Light gives us the power of vision with the help of our eyes. So eyes are also very important organs which are given by our God gift. They are the God gift for all of us. Wonderful organs which help us to see the things around us. So to see the things around us, we need light. So light is a form of energy which enables us to see the nature, which provides us the power of vision. Then how do we see the objects? You are all able to see me. You are all able to see around you, so many things around you. It's all possible when the light falls on that object and the object gives out, object reflects the light. When the light falls on the objects reflect the light. The reflected light, when it reaches our eyes, we'll be able to see the image of those objects. So we see the objects when the emitted light or reflected light from the object reach our eyes. There are sources of light, like tube light is there, filament bulbs are there, LED bulbs are there, candle light is there, and sunlight is there. These are all sources of light. So these are all emitting light, and those sources of light which give out their own light, they are called as luminous bodies. Luminous bodies such as stars, sun and all, these are all luminous bodies. So from such luminous bodies, the light gets emitted, and when such light reach our eyes, we see the objects. Next, we have already studied in the lower classes that light travels in straight line. Whenever light falls on any opaque object, it casts sharp shadow of that object. It shows that light travels in straight line. Based on this property of light travels in straight line, we mainly study in this topic reflection and refraction. Reflection and refraction. Before we go into the details of reflection and refraction, we should know certain simple terms such as what is a ray of light, what is a beam of light, and what is parallel beam of light. Ray of light, it is a line in the direction of light. The line which is drawn in the direction of light is called as ray of light. Then, if it is a bunch of rays of light traveling in a particular direction, that bunch of rays of light gives rise to beam of light. Beam means bunch. Bunch of rays of light. Then what is a parallel beam of light? Bunch of parallel rays of light in a particular direction gives you parallel beam of light. Okay, these are simple terms. Now next, what happens when light falls on any matter? When the light falls on any matter, basically three things take place. Part of that light is absorbed, partly it is reflected, and partly it is transmitted. For example, when you go and sit or stand in front of a source of water, you will be able to see your face. Not only you will be able to see the face, you will be able to see the depth of water, and you will be able to see the base of that water. The bottom of that water can also be seen. It means when the light falls, part of that light is reflected. So you will be able to see your image, that is due to reflection. And part of light is transmitted. The light gets transmitted through the water and part of it is absorbed. Means some part of it is absorbed by the matter. So three things happen: absorption, reflection and transmission. Means whenever the light falls on a matter, when the light interacts with the matter, three things happen. Part of it is absorbed, which is called as absorption of light. Part of it is reflected, it is called reflection of light. And part of it is transmitted, it is called transmission of light. Okay. We are mainly studying about reflection and refraction. First, let us start with reflection. What is the meaning of reflection? When a ball is thrown on a ball, or when the ball is dropped on the floor, the ball bounces back. This is called bouncing back of ball. It is also called as reflection. Similarly, when the light falls on any surface, such as a polished surface or plain mirror, the light gets reflected. Means bouncing back of rays of light from a highly polished surface is called as reflection. In simple terms, bouncing back of rays of light is called as reflection of light. And you have studied already in the lower classes, laws of reflection. There are basically two laws. When the light incidents on a highly polished surface, that highly polished surface we can take it as a plane mirror. When the light incidents on a highly polished surface, it gets reflected. During this reflection, the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. This is called as first law. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. And similarly, the second law states that the incident ray at the point of incidence, the incident ray, reflected ray at the point of incidence, and the normal rod at the point of incidence. Once again, incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal drawn at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. Incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal drawn at the point of incidence all lie on the same plane.